Former Union Minister as well as BJP MP in Rajya Sabha, Mr. KJ Alphonse now joins us. Mr. Alphonse, thank you very much for speaking to NDTV. My first question, will the Prime Minister be able to convince the farmers? That's the most important and significant question as of this moment.
He spoke in the Rajya Sabha and then he spoke in the Lok Sabha today. And I think you see the argument is very, very simple. See, ever since I was an IAS probationer 40 years back, we have been talking about reforms in the agriculture sector and about abolition of PMC and of course amendment to the Essential Commodities Act on contract farming. We've been talking, having many commissions to study this. Their recommendations have been before various governments, even the last government, and they all said we need to liberalize the agriculture sector because we can't have 50% of people contributing only 14-15% to the GDP of the country. And the only way to do is to increase productivity. And finally, after so much of talking and consultations, this country has moved, this government came up with the Agri Laws. And according to me, what is the problem? Because you see, if you take the last government, it was Manmohan Singh government from 1991, which completely liberalized the economy, allowed, gave freedom to industrialists, gave freedom to individuals to dream their dreams and to create jobs. It is the same procedure. We have bound to the agriculture sector, to the farmers, to the APMC, and we said you shall sell only in this particular market. What is this government and what is this law saying? Saying that, sorry, the farmer shall have the liberty to sell anywhere. Now, I can't understand why under the sun anybody can have an objection when the farmer is given the liberty to sell anywhere, maybe in his own farm gate, in any market, in the existing APMC. What really is the problem? I don't understand. And if MSP is a problem, then look at the track history of Modi government. I mean, the proof of the pudding is ultimately in the eating. Look at the MSP for paddy from 1,345 rupees per quintal, it's gone up to 1,888 rupees. And for wheat, it's gone up from 1,350, it's gone up to 1,925. Look at the quantity of wheat and paddy which has been procured. It's almost double of what was procured 5 years back by the UPA. And look at the money paid. The amount of money paid for wheat has been about 72.5% more than what was paid the 5 years before us. This 5 years we have paid 72.5% more than what has been paid 5 years ago by the UPA. And take for example Samuk Paddy. We have paid 137.4% more than in 5 years than what has been paid by the UPA government. Now I don't understand, if we have increased the MSP by about 42% for wheat and for paddy, if the quantity has gone up dramatically, if the number of farmers who are benefited has more than doubled, and this Prime Minister and the government is saying we had MSP before, we have MSP today and we shall have MSP tomorrow, what really is the problem? I don't understand at all. I mean, I've been in public life for 40 years. I'm not able to comprehend what really is the problem, unless of course it's a political one, because they cannot beat Modi at the electoral politics, because Modi has been elected by the vast majority of people of this country. He's come to power a second time. You can't throw him out. So the only way you think you can do it is by organizing farmers, by spreading lies. I mean, what the opposition is doing is telling lies that Modi government has done nothing. I give you all the figures. Is it not a lot? Take also under the Pradhan Mantri Samman Nidhi, this government has paid 1,13,000 crores to the farmers. We have given ration to 80 crore people.
I agree with all of that, Mr. Alphonse. But you know, the opposition, Mr. Alphonse, says that what sort of trust are you going to build with the farmers when you are calling those who are protesting Andolan Jeevis? I mean, is this going to send a positive message?
See, when you spread lies that the Modi government has nothing, that the Modi government is against the farmers, that the Modi government is going to abolish MSP, that you cannot sell your agriculture product anywhere, aren't you telling lies? Aren't you spreading lies which is going to go against the India? That's my basic question. Look at what happened on the 26th of January. I mean, hosting that flag in Red Fort, the symbol of India's freedom, I think that was ultimate treason. Why? Because there are people, political parties, which have been spreading the lies. So when you keep spreading the lies that you don't get justice, how did the Khalistan movement come out? Very simple. People of Punjab were told, India is not doing justice to you. That is how the Khalistani movement was built up. How did the Marxist movement come about? Very simple. When you tell people, look here, the government is not on your side, they have done nothing, therefore you need to eliminate the government. See? And therefore, these battles are fought in the mind. So when you tell lies, the opposition, the Congress, the communists, and also all those Akalis and everybody who gets together, and you spread lies, it leads to people doing such things as what happened on the 26th of January.
Yeah.
And that is not acceptable.
No, I agree. But, you know, there's a very thin line, Mr. Alphonse, because a lot of people turn around and say that this almost appears as if the government is trying to build an argument for no criticism or no parallel opposition, no opposition at all. And that is an uncomfortable situation to be in. Anyway, my final question to you, Mr. Alphonse, is that there is also a view that the government only wants to ram its version of the law and does not want to listen to any criticism about this law, any parallel opinion about the law, that my version the best.
See, I can repeat what I said, the figures. You see, I'm a person who talks numbers. The Prime Minister talks numbers. We have done things. Then why? And the Prime Minister said, I'm a phone call away. See, the Agriculture Minister and senior ministers had series of meetings, the 11 meetings with the farmers. Now, and he asked them, now, tell us what you need us to do. You want modifications, amendment to the Act? Tell us. No, they're not willing to talk. Now, how do you have a conversation like that? See, I think the Modi government has been absolutely open to a dialogue with the farmers, with anybody, on any ideas, on any amendments. You want to have more assurances? The government has been willing. But you see, if you're a group of people who just refuse to listen and refuse to listen to reason, what can we say? I mean, I think it's extremely unfortunate. We need to concentrate on bigger things. The pandemic has destroyed the economy. I think we all need to work together. I think this is a time when the ruling as well as the opposition should come together and say, hey, let's work with the government.
Thank you much for joining us on Trending Tonight.